you didn't have a good night. There needed to be, you know, certain things discovered. And I love organic phenomenon. And that has led me to various things. And it led me to one day calling a veterinarian. And I asked him if he had a dead cat. And he said, "No, sir, I don't." And I explained to him, he said, what do you want a dead cat for? And I said, I want to study this cat. And so something, he at first pegged me for a total nutcake. And then something caught him. And he took my number. And lo and behold, 10 minutes later, the same guy, veterinarian, calls me and he says, "I have a cat. I can't believe it." I get off the phone. 2 minutes later, in it comes. Had to put it to sleep, and you can have this cat. And he asked me that it would never show up in a film. In the film. So, or be recognizable. So I had to set up in my basement there. And I drove down and got the cat in a cardboard box. And just before lunch, I put it into a jar filled with formaldehyde. And it went in like a slinky. It just lay down in the formaldehyde. And then I went upstairs and had lunch and came back down and I went to get the cat out of the jar and it had gotten rigor mortis. And this had a narrow top. It was like trying to pull a steel cat out of a glass jar. And so I finally got this thing out of there. And I had a whole set up on the workbench, my idea of an operating theater, and I went to work getting inside this cat. And when I opened up the inside, it was unbelievable. And it's if you've seen Fellini's Roma, it was. The organs inside the cat were brilliant colors. And as soon as the air got to the organs, the color just started draining out right before your eyes. Just draining away before your eyes. Just like when they'd open up these, you know, things under the city and these ancient things were perfect and the air starts getting to them and they start fading. So, but studying this cat was kind of, you know, important. And there were these tanks and oil wells. And you couldn't see them from the street because they had this donut of earth around in case the tanks blew out. So you'd climb up over these things and down into a brand new world. And that was one of the greatest finds. And right next to where this happened, there was a narrow tank coming up out of the ground, and it was surrounded by a donut of water. But just down at the bottom of the water, there was tar. Who knows how thick it was? And tar preserves things. And the cat, it served many purposes. But I lowered this cat in there, and then about a year later came back and pulled the wire, and the cat came out impregnated with tar. And I laid the cat down on the ground and came back another year later, and it was a perfect marriage of cat and earth. Tar impregnated cat in earth. And I have a photograph of that. But the cat did end up in a scene, but it was unrecognizable.